Sure enough, it is a cave, and I was not sure if it was. So, I'm glad to have made it in here. But we have to be careful. I've already been in there once, and it's quite incredible. But through the cave to the other side is another hive. And I didn't anger them, but they all started coming out again, so I had to, well, I shouldn't have rushed out, that was pretty careless of me, but if they begin to come out again, I will be more cautious and slow, and, because I definitely bumped my head on that spike there. So, let's go. Okay. So, in the cave, I'm not going to talk that loud because I don't want to disturb them, but in the cave and on the ground, there's like a plethora of little bones. Let me tell you what, this whole experience, I'm really glad I came here, because this whole experience is an extremely mindful experience. So to add hiking, walking to my, well, I guess rock climbing and caving to my list of activities to do to help my mental health, I'd say that this is a pretty good option to allow you to be in the present moment. Yeah, there's so many bones, so I don't know if things come here to die, or if something brings things here to eat them. There's just, I saw a jawbone, here it is. Some sort of rodent, I believe. A tooth. So I don't know if things come here to die or if things are brought here and eaten. Either way, it's pretty amazing. Here's a nice... Wow. Definitely a rodent. So many things have been eaten here. It's just filled with bones everywhere. Here it is. This kind of looks like the top of a skull. Carefully. And the first time I went in, I didn't know that there was another hive through here. I don't know what eats in here. When the bees started all kind of coming out, it started sounding like water. Like, it was really cool, because they were just, I watched them just begin to appear out of
out of their hive. And it just got more and more and more. But now they're all back in their hive. Not all of them, some of them are still out. They're starting to come out. You can see one of them. It's pretty incredible. There's one. And there's still much, much more to explore. Sorry for all the twistings and turnings. Okay, so rather than reading today, I decided that I was going to learn from nature. And beautifully enough, I get to learn from caves. Beautiful view. So here is what I have learned. What can be learned from the bee? Build your home into a sturdy, shady rock overhang on the north side of a mountain. It's pretty interesting because now I've seen there's four hives that I've seen here, and I've seen another hive very similar to these ones on Pico Show Peak. And it too is on the north side of a mountain where there's pretty much no sun, like, at all. It's pretty much constantly in the shade. So I wonder if that's just a thing that bees do, where they build their hives on the north side of the mountains. It's interesting. So, find a nice shady place to live, especially if you're in Arizona. Let your home form through flow in crested waves. So I kind of take that as a don't try and make your home like this perfect thing. Just let it form itself and take time to develop it. And as you develop it over time, it will flow and it will take the shape that you desire. But don't rush it. Don't push it. Just take your time. Shadowy places are the best places to live. And I like that because yesterday I had quite a depressed day. And I was just like, oh, I can't. I don't want to get out of my little cave house. I'm just having trouble just functioning. Just don't have much energy. And I just stayed inside most of the day. And it was good. And it took care of me. So if you gotta live in your shadow for a little while, that's completely okay. Protect yourself from the elements. Live somewhere where you can survey the land around you. And of the 5 beehives that I have found so far, they've all been in high elevated areas where they can like see for a long, long ways. And they're all in these rocky structures. Have the high ground. There's no difference between family, colony, home, and work. And I think that one's really cool because the bees, they live in these colonies, these hives, but their work, their home, their family, their friends, everything is in that hive. Yes, they leave to go gather pollen, but they all work together and they're all family together. And so that's pretty cool because if you can take that, the way that bees live, and incorporate it into your own life, and that the people that I work with, they are my family too. And the people I live with, they are my family too. We're all part of a colony, we're all the same species, we all work together. And if you can view humanity as such, then it's just kind of beautiful. So I will work harder to view the people that I work with as my family, as my colony, as my hive. Babies that live in the hive, whether it's my nieces and nephews or my animal companions, whoever I care for, view them as part of the family too. Bonding watching bees, like, and just realizing that they are so connected. It's all the same: family, colony, hive, work, home, friends, enemies. It's all the same. Nourish the hive. So take the time to nourish my hive. Work together, dance together, communicate through dance. Caves, rocks, cliffs are the best. It might be a little rocky. Lol, there's rocks everywhere. I might end up turning the camera again, just like I did earlier, because I was too in the moment. I was too excited. I was focusing on that upsetting bubble. harder to go on an adventure. With one hand, check out the saguaro. Looks like he's starting to get frosted on the side. He's turning red. He has a baby saguaro. So many years from now, this is the upper portion that is forming into the cave, so it will probably eventually all connect together. You can see the bees coming out. This was the other hole that let light shine through. It's kind of tricky because the only way to get a better view in is to cross their path that they're flying in. I don't want to disrupt their path. Because I'm sure they're not used to having visitors. Without making them upset. Wow, that's actually really deep down in there. Huh, what a good home. It's pretty cool. Pretty cool.
past their path now, so I might be able to. Wow. It's beautiful. It's cool seeing a hive from above, because all the other ones have been below them.
This cave is just going to open up more and more and more.
That's really neat. There's so many of these. Alright.
Okay, so that is it for this video. I don't know what's gonna be over this other cliffside. I definitely don't want to climb back down the way I came up because it's really steep. So I'm probably just gonna hang out up here all day at these cliffs. This is such a beautiful experience, guys. If you are similar to me and you are working on your mental health, I strongly suggest just taking the time to go out by yourself on an adventure and see where it takes you, because if you find something that's really cool, it just encaptures your mind entirely and there's nothing else you can think about except for the present moment. And if you don't find something cool, that's okay too. Still just work on being present and enjoying the experiences around you. And of course, I know everyone's not an adventurer like me, but find your own way. Find your own path and what works for you. Alright? I love you guys, and I hope that you can learn something from the bees.